More of those wretched things. Must have been fishing when these monsters came. Bad luck. Fresh water. There must be a settlement somewhere nearby.
Dora. What? Stop! Not another step or I'll... Wait. It's you. You're the one who tried to free me on the ship. At least you made the effort.
Suddenly, you see what she sees. Feel what she feels. Confusion. Resolve. And a hint of gratitude.
Did you feel that? You've got the same thing I do, in your head. The same. It must be that tadpole they put in our eyes. I assume that's what caused our minds to cross. These things are going to consume us from the inside and turn us into mind flayers. You and I need a healer. Finding one won't be easy in this wilderness. We'll need supplies. I'm hoping something of use might be behind this door, but I've barely made a dent in it so far. I was thinking the same thing. Around the top of this cliff, perhaps. Hopefully, there's no more of these creatures along the way. Or just company for our final moments. But you're right. Whatever lies ahead will be a little less daunting with support. You can call me Shadowheart. Lead the way.
Sakura!
Better stay back. One strike could be lethal.
Thank you.
I need help.
Hurry. I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? I was hoping for a kind soul. Well, not to worry. I saw you on the ship, strutting about whilst I was trapped in that pod. What did you and those tentacled freaks do to me? You'll talk. I can... Ah!
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light, the fear.
What was that? What's going on? It's those tentacled monsters. Whatever they did to us caused that link. They took you too. I saw it during whatever just happened. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. A kindred spirit. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. My, my. You've been busy. So, did you learn anything about these worms while wandering the ship? No. Of that much we can be certain. These worms are already affecting me. I can feel it. Now, what to do about it? You know, I was ready to go this alone, but maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And anyone that can crash a mind flayer ship and walk away seems like a good person to know. All right. I accept. Lead on.
Something the matter?
Nice view.
grooves in the mud around that rock.
More survivors?
They're
trying to dig somebody out of the wreckage.
Something's wrong.
So much blood.
They should be trying to get away if they had any sense.
Come on, dig! Faster! Get her out of there! Don't die! Don't die! Don't die!
The person they're trying to save, it's the creature from the ship. Still alive, but wounded. Your words fall on deaf ears. The creature's hold on them is too strong.
Monster! That's my daughter! She's dying! You did this! You want to kill her!
Suddenly, something convulses inside you. Your vision lurches sickeningly. You are one with your assailants, your minds fused together. They are frightened, lost. The creature in the wreckage is forcing them to attack you, controlling them like puppets. Its voice shivers across your brain, seeking access, trying to bend your will to its bidding. The presence in your mind gropes for purchase and finds the tadpole instead. You push back, taking advantage of a tremor of pain that cuts through the creature. As its influence wanes, your assailants lower their weapons, blinking in confusion.
Where are we? There was fire in the sky and then... Oh, God. Sona! What happened to my friend? Gods. I think you're right. It called out from the wreckage. Sounded just like my daughter. But she's been dead for years. That thing got into our heads, drove us mad. We wrecked our boat just trying to get close to it. What do we do now? We're nowhere. That's the point. Even with a boat, Baldur's Gate is days. Wait. You. I can feel you. Just like one of those things. You're one of them! There's something in your head. Please, we'll take our chances out here. Just leave us be.
Simpletons. The beast was half dead and they still bowed to its whims. We had worms forced into our skulls. We weren't fawning over the bloody things. It's not even remotely the same.
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now. If only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. You can't move, can't think. Thinking is mercifully done for you. It will be a joy to serve, to die for it, an honor. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then, the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
Footprints. There may be even more than survived the crash.
That's unexpected. Last I saw you, you were lying in a crucible's worth of blood. An intellect devourer nibbling at your ear. Glad to see my eyes deceive me. I'm Gale. Well met. Very same. A traumatizing experience, if an instructive one.
Yes.
The ocular penetration by an illithid tadpole, which will end with our souls being snuffed like strands of weave caught in dead magic. Not to mention, you're staring at me like a Rashimi at a blackboard. You're no wizard, are you? Pity. But that'll have to wait. The primary need now is a healer. I take it you recall the insertion of the parasite? Are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it'll turn us into mind flayers? A process known as seramorphosis? It is to be avoided. I assume you're no accomplished healer, either. Powerful cleric, maybe? I gather as much. We'll have to look for a solution elsewhere. You and I are in a whole lot of trouble. We need help. And I'm not sure where we'll find it in this wilderness. How about we embark on the quest for a healer together? Most excellent. Then, without further ado, let's be off. Besides, looks like you keep some interesting company. A woman with shadows for eyes, deep as the dark lake. Pleasure, madam.
Is it indeed? We'll see.
Broken. Must have been here a while.
Zoru was right. Yellow as a toad, twice as ugly.
The thing's dangerous.
Leave it for the goblins to kill.
And if it escapes, how will you... Oh, a guest.
Your skull pounds in response to the prisoner's white-hot stare. Her lips don't move, yet you hear her voice.
You again. Get rid of them.
He's right. Let's go. We need to check out that blast. You didn't hear it? Shook our camp good, so we came for a look. Northwest. Look for Nettie. Whatever your wound, she can mend it.
And be careful. There are goblin traps everywhere.
Nymessa, come.
Enough gawking. Get me down. Never.
Observe and listen.
Enough dawdling.
You'll
get me down.
Before you see them.
The tadpole hasn't yet scrambled all your senses. Auspicious. But the longer we wait, the more it consumes. My people possess the cure for this infection. I must find a creche. You will join me. Lies. Just get rid of her. It is many things. A hatchery, a training grounds, a shelter. Githyanki protocol is clear. When infected with a Geek tadpole, we must report to a caretaker for purification. You are full up. Dismiss your weakest warrior. Very well. But I cannot wait long. Nor can you.
You're both twice as tall as me, but have half the bloody backbone.
But we don't know what that thing even is. And what about the crypt?
I'm telling you, it's a ship. And the crypt can wait. Mari and Barton have been trying to break in for days. Now we... Stop! Got ourselves competition already. That's our ship. First you look, then you touch, then you take. The only thing we're sharing with you is our pointy ends. Get him!
Perhaps our survival isn't such a distant prospect.
I can't wait to sleep.
Thank you, Gimblebok. Everything all right out there?
Oh, I told him it wasn't safe out there. Get inside and I'll rustle up some bandages.
No more prayers, only dust and silence.
Who are those prayers for? Normally the patron god is Orpheus, not here.
Ancient, indecipherable text covers the plaque.
A dead tongue. Whoever worshipped here must be long gone.
Thank you.
poco a vida.
jungle.
How does it open?
You do not recognize the language on the plaque.
What's that? Wasn't built for the living. Armed scribes, but no sign of a struggle.
I wonder what was so subversive about their words that they commanded protection.
That's Jurgle, scribe of the dead. I didn't think anyone still worshipped him. Looks like someone wanted to bury their secrets.
This book is far lighter than it should be, with such a massive lock. The lock opens. A loose page comes with it. Magic pulses from the parchment. What was once script is now an obliterated scrawl. You have a sense these are names, a list, but of what? The longer you stare at the dark and decimated words, the more your head aches. There is no meaning to be found here. Inscription is in a language unknown to you. Inscription is in a language unknown to you. Inscription is in a language unknown to you.
That might be worth a look.
Something just woke up. Thank you.
Ignis!
Rising from the dead just to protect some dusty baubles. Fools. Please, save your regrets. This place isn't worthy of them. Let's move.
lot of effort to hide one sarcophagus.
So he has spoken, and so thou standest before me, right as always. What a curious way to awaken. Now I have a question for thee. What is the worth of a single mortal's life? An arbiter of certain matters. But that is not important now. Wilt thou answer my question? So, I ask again. What is the worth of a single mortal life? Thus, balance is achieved. If all are at war, none can win. Very well. I am satisfied. We have met, and I know thy face. We will see each other again at the proper time and place. Farewell.
Something the matter?
Something over there. that might be worth a look. Something over there. I can't see any way to disarm it. I can't see any way to disarm it.